In this video, we will talk about getting started with the Nuera Smart Camera. So, Nuera Smart Camera is an industry-grade machine-to-machine camera which is used for industrial automation. So, the Nuera Smart Camera comes with the inbuilt processing unit, and it also an IP67 rated camera which comes with an enclosure with an integrated lighting. So, if you see, it is having integrated ring lighting, and you can able to customize the lens according to your application. So it also has two ports, power and I/O ports and gigabit ethernet communication. So the power and I/O port supports 24 volt input power, and it also supports two digital inputs and two 24 volt compatible output, and also provide RS-232 output through the I/O connections. Now we will see how to switch on the camera. So accessories which are required to power on the Nuera Smart Camera are 24 volt industrial grade power supply, which we will be supplying along with the camera. And we will be supplying 1.5 meter power and I/O cable. The cable comes with a circular connector, and another end of the connector will be 2 pin for connecting the power, and 3 pin for connecting a trigger and taking some I/Os. And we will be supplying a gigabit ethernet connector. Again, one end of the cable will be a circular connector, and another one will be an RJ45 connector. Take the power I/O cable, and you can see there will be a power I/O connector, and you can see a white marking in the connector and also in the mating part of the connector. You can just take and press fit the connector, it will lock. So if you want to remove the cable, you just pull out the external ring, and you can pull out the cable, you can easily come out. So to mate it again, connect it as a press fit. In the same way, you can see the gigabit ethernet cable with a circular connector with a white marking in the cable, and again mate the connector in the same way how we have done with the power cable. Now the power cable is connected, and the 24 volt power supply is connected to the power cable by using this 2 pin connector, and you can see the gigabit ethernet cable is connected to the PC through the RJ45. Now I will be switching on the camera. When you are switching on the camera, you can see the user system LED will be turning red, and it will take nearly 10 seconds to boot. So once it is booted, it will become green color, and you can see the camera will be start streaming. Okay, you can see the LED light from the camera is start working. Now, you go to your PC. After powering on the camera, go to your wired connection of your laptop, and go to your Ethernet setting page, and make sure the setting is set to manual mode with IPv4 setting as manual, and IP address of your laptop should be in 192.168.1.series. For more details how to set your laptop to manual connection, refer the online documentation. Press apply, then close this window. Open any one of your browser. The recommended browser is Google Chrome, and enter the IP address of the camera. The IP address of the camera which is we are working on is 192.168.1.221. So typically the IP address of the camera will be mentioned in your package. So you can enter the IP address of the camera and press enter. Now the web GUI which is running inside the camera will be loaded here, and you can see the camera is live streaming the images. Now I am showing my hand in front of the camera, so you can see the live images which are updating in the window. And this GUI, this project template application, the sample demo application shown here is having some functions for you to go through and evaluate. So there is a streaming application, there is an apply thresholding, check brightness and ROI feedback. Now I am going to explain about the apply thresholding. Select the apply thresholding button. Now you can see the OpenCV image processing is happening, and it is showing an apply thresholding function here. Now I am going to move the object, and you can see the live feedback of the image update here with the thresholding function. You can change the thresholding function values by changing the threshold value and press enter here. Now you can see the value of 100 is applied on the threshold value, and it is changing its function. So the camera is also having other features for configuring the sensor applications. Now you can see there is a basic info here which is explaining about the software version of the camera, and it also has an hardware version and Mac ID loaded and important other features and the firmware version of the camera. And there is an image sensor section where you can switch the camera between enable mode, trigger continuous mode.
By selecting this enable trigger mode, the camera will be set in trigger application. After selecting that, you have to press update. Now you can see there is no update is happening in from the camera as the camera is put on the trigger mode. Just disable this and press update, and you can see the camera again started streaming in a continuous mode. So there are other sensor configurations are provided here, which we will be talking about in detail in other settings, other videos. And you can see there are basic sensor setting configurations are available here, and you can see the IP address of the camera and its network configurations and other peripherals. You can see the strobe lighting functions, everything. And again, there is a section for application, and where you can select between different kinds of threshold value. This is for a demo purpose. Now we are given an invert threshold function, and again you can control the value or thresholding value from this control. Yeah. Now again I will be switching back to the streaming video, and you can see the live image update here. Thanks for watching this video, and we will be talking about more features of Nuera smart camera in other videos. Thanks for watching it.